If you've ever had to analyze large amounts of data, such as sales data, real estate data, or even your own personal finances, chances are you've tried to do this in Excel. And if you don't know anything about pivot tables, getting any useful information might have been a bit of a pain. In this quick tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use pivot tables in Microsoft Excel. For this example, I've downloaded just some real estate sales data from Sacramento, California, and I really have no idea what it is, but to be honest with you, that's not the point of this tutorial. It's to use pivot tables and not necessarily the actual data itself. So let's start off with what a pivot table is. Basically, it will group and sum data in any form or fashion that you want. So if you want to look at all three-bedroom homes in Sacramento or two-bedroom condos in Rio Linda, a pivot table will do that for you very easily. Now, you might have used something called filters, which will get you partially the way there. So let's go ahead and add some filters, and I'll show you what I mean. So let's go up to our Data tab and click the little Filter button, and it adds a little drop-down list to all of your fields. So now you can go to, say, your city and deselect everything, but reselect, say, Antelope. And it shows you all of the real estate transactions in Antelope. You can go one step further and go to the beds and deselect everything, but find all of the three-bedroom homes in Antelope. You can do the same thing for other cities, such as, say, Auburn. And you find that there's only one transaction made in this particular time period. Now, we could do this all day long for all the different cities, for all the different bedrooms, for all the different types of houses, but that will be a little bit laborious. So what a pivot table will do is do all of these calculations for you all automatically. So let me turn everything back on and let's go ahead and add a pivot table. It's found on your Insert tab. So once you go to Insert, you'll see a little tab called Pivot Table. Now, we're not going to do anything fancy here. It doesn't matter where you click on your data table here, it will automatically get all of that data. There is one caveat that you can't have any blank rows in your data. So just do a quick visual scan, scroll through all of your data, and make sure you don't have any blank rows in there. If you do, the pivot table will generally stop at that blank row. We have a clean set of data here, so let's go ahead and add a pivot table. It automatically picks the range of data for us, and it creates it on a new sheet. So what this pivot table allows me to do, let me drag my little dialog over so you can see it a little easier. I can specify what the row labels are, what the column labels are, and any values that I want to do a sum or an average or a count or a max or a min or any other kind of a cool thing. Build sort of like a mini table with all of this information added up for you. You also have a report filter, so if you want to do a high level thing like show me only the data from 2005 and 2006 or 2015 only, you can do that. Let's get started. Let's go ahead and add a city to our row labels. And how about the sales price for our individual, for each of these rows? So we can see the sum price of all of the sales in Antelope was 7.6 million. Auburn was 2.02 million, and you can see on down the list. That's pretty handy information there, but you can take this one step further. We can go to our sum values, we can drop down this little selection list, go to our field settings, and instead of summing, we can do an average. So we can see the average price in each one of these cities. We can also do a max, a min, and a variety of other things. To give you an example what max looks like, we'll just click it, and the most expensive house sold in Antelope was $408,000. And again, this is just some downloaded data for a specific time period that I don't really know or particularly care about. That's good for just that particular city, but what if we want to know for each of the individual bedroom houses? So we're going to add another column up here for beds. And unfortunately, it puts it in the sum value, which I don't want. So I'm going to drag the sum of beds, drag this up into column labels, and now it's showing me for a zero-bedroom house, a one-bedroom house, two-bedroom, so on and so forth, that I've got the individual max sales price for each of those homes in that number of beds for that house. Now, you might notice a zero bed. That was data probably keyed in wrong. We can easily get rid of that. So we'll go to the column labels, drop the list down, and we can choose which of these columns is to be displayed. And I don't want the zero, so I'll uncheck it. Now we can see that we have all of the data for our one bedroom all the way up to our eight bedroom house. Now notice that whenever I deselect the pivot table, that little field selection dialog goes away, but whenever I do select that pivot table, it seems to come back. If you make the mistake of closing this down, you'll have to manually select that, bring that dialog up just by right-clicking the pivot table and showing the field list. All right, we can do a few other things to this data here. If we want to know these houses, you might recall back in our original data that we had some homes that were residential, some were condos, and some were multifamily and a variety of other things. Let's go ahead and add that to our pivot table. So let's go to our, I think it was called type, and we'll add type, and we can see that we have in Antelope, we have a condo, and it was sold for $115,000. Again, that was the max price. And the residential two-bedroom home was $180,000 or so. And you can see how it sums this, or gives you the max price for each one of these things. If you wish to change the sort order of that, you can always drag this type in your row labels above the city, and it shows you everything kind of categorized by condo, then multifamily, then residential, and then the actual city itself. Just a different way of looking at it. If you want to look at only the residential, all you need to do is grab that type, drag it up to the report filter, and it puts it up to the very top level here. Then on this type where it says all, that little drop-down list will allow me to select whatever data that I want to see. Now for some reason it doesn't have these cute little check boxes up here. In Microsoft Excel, just select the select multiple items and deselect what you don't want. Now we can see that we have Antelope, we have a two-bedroom house that sold for $180,000 and $350,000 for a three-bedroom house, and so on and so forth. So you get the idea of what a pivot table can do. Basically, it takes large amounts of data and groups it so you can do some summing, some averaging, and some counting of your data. Well, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to comment.